be here. Herman's got pictures on Monday, so Herman's not here Monday. Okay, so we're finding somebody. All right, over here. That's all. Okay. Watlow Skin's going to be here on 8/21. We also have to schedule felonies if they do a mold trial on IPWFS 14. Also, Press 2, we got to look at Rebel Speaker. We're going to have to run IPWFS 11 and 12 Monday.
Okay.
So we got to run that Monday. So we got
to get that ready for Monday.
Okay. Monday or Tuesday. So the material will get here. Okay. So those are some hot things going on. All right. Panasonic will be here Tuesday with RTP.
Okay.
All right. So that's got to be a press.
I'm going to do that in 25.
Press 25? All right. All right. So Panasonic will be here with RTP on Tuesday. So. Okay. All right. So trying to figure out. I thought last weekend I talked to a lot of people about Elgin. It was pretty interesting to hear about Elgin. What it's all about and everything, and how special people came from this town. But so today there's a little something in history that I think it's sort of interesting. A lot of us, some of us lived it, some of us didn't live it. But in an evening televised address, President Richard M. Nixon announced his intention to become the first president in American history to resign, with impeachment proceedings underway against him for the involvement in Watergate affair. Nixon was finally bowing to the pressure from the public and Congress to leave the White House. By taking this action, he said, with his own address to the Oval Office, "I hope that I will never hasten the start of the process of healing, which is so desperately needed in America." Just before noon the next day, Nixon officially ended his term as the 37th President of the United States. Before departing his family in a helicopter from the White House lawn, he smiled farewell, and enigmatically, we've raised his arms in a victory or peace salute. The helicopter door was then closed, and then Nixon family began their journey home to San Clemente, California. Minutes later, Vice President Gerald R. Ford was sworn in as the 38th President of the United States in the East Room of the White House. After taking the oath of office, President Ford spoke to the nation in a televised address, declaring, "My fellow Americans, our long national nightmare is over." He later pardoned Nixon for any crimes that he may have committed while in the White House, explaining that he wanted to end the national divisions created by the Watergate scandal. Alright, so just a little bit of history today, so it's the only time that it's happened, okay? So, on June 17, 1972, five men, including a salaried security coordinator for President Nixon's re-election committee, were arrested for breaking into illegally wiretapping the Democratic National Committee headquarters in Washington, D.C. Watergate complex. Soon after, two other former White House aides were implicated in the break-in, but the Nixon administration denied any involvement. Later that year, reporters Carl Bernstein and Bob Woodward of the Washington Post discovered the higher echelon of conspiracy surrounding the incident and political scandal unprecedented magnitude erupted. In July, the existence of what were to be called the Watergate tapes, officially reporting the White House conversation between Nixon and staff, was revealed during the Senate hearing. Cox subpoenaed the tapes, and after 3 months of delay, President Nixon agreed to send summaries of the recordings. Cox rejected the summaries, and Nixon fired him. His successor as special prosecutor, Leon Jaworski, leveled indictments against several high-ranking administration officials, including Mitchell and Dean, who were duly convicted. Public confidence in the president rapidly waned, and by the end of 1974, the White House Judiciary Committee had adopted 3 articles of impeachment against President Nixon. Obstruction of justice, abuse of presidential powers, and hindrance of the impeachment process. On July 30th, under a concern from the Supreme Court, Nixon finally released the Watergate tapes. On August 5th, transcripts of the recordings were released, including the segment in which the president was instructing Haldeman to order the FBI to halt the Watergate investigation. 3 days later, Nixon announced his resignation. Again, he resigned. There's no such thing as being impeached. So just some little FYI. So if there's things against somebody, you resign from office, okay? Alright, we're going to watch some more of this video, because I think some of us will appreciate the next thing he talks about.